बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अल्लाहुम्मा सल्ली अला मोहम्मद व अला आल मोहम्मद। ओके माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर इन एक्सरसाइज 10.3। इट इज़ यूक्लिडियन ज्योमेट्री। सो वी विल सॉल्व क्वेश्चन नंबर 11। वी आर इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 11। लेट्स सी व्हाट इट सेज। इट सेज दैट डिटरमिन द डायरेक्शन कोसाइंस ऑफ द लाइन गिवन बाय द इक्वेशन। If you see, these are two equations, okay? You can see very clearly. Okay, so my dear student, you can see these equation very clearly. So these two equation represent actually a line. So if they represent a line, so also find the equations of straight line passing through the point 5 -3 2 and parallel to the line given above. What we need to do, my dear student, ek line given hai, hame is given line ke direction cosines talash karne hain, and once the direction cosines of this given line are found out, what we will do, we will find the equation of another line which is actually passing through this point in the space 5 -3 2 and which is parallel to this given line. So that is the task. So let's see how to find the direction cosines of the given line. So I come to the solution manual. Equations of the given line are, you see, I hope you can see, the equations of the given line are, ye given line ke general equations hain, theek hai. First you add these two equations. Why we add them? Because we are going to change these two equations into symmetric form, and once they are changed into the symmetric form, in the denominator hamare paas iske direction ratios aa jayenge ya direction cosines aa jayenge. To hamara target ye hai, we need to convert this general form of equations into the symmetric form. So this is our target, and in this way we will get the direction cosines. Now simply, when you simply add 1 and 2, when you simply add 1 and 2, what will happen? Z will cancel with Z, and we will get a single equation in x and y, this single equation in x and y. Then what you do, shifting all the values to the other side, when you shift all the values to the other side, we will get this expression, x plus 2 by 5 is equal to y by minus 1. So once you eliminated z, now this time you eliminate x, ek dafa aapne z ko cancel kiya, then you get this relation. Okay, now you eliminate if you see the two equation, this is the second equation, there is already no x, so no need to net x because in this equation we don't have x. Simply shifting all the values to the other side, and we will have again like this equation. If you see, we can now equate these two equations because the right hand side of this equation and left hand side of this equation are equal, so we can combining 3 and 4 equations. Of course, there are 3 and 4 equations, the new one. So x plus 2 by 5 is equal to y by minus 1 is equal to z minus 3 by 2. If you see, this is a symmetric form of equation of the line. Symmetric form. ये symmetric में बदल गया. ये general में था, ये ऊपर दो, और ये symmetric में बदल गया. This is symmetric form. Why we have changed into the symmetric? Because in this way we got the direction ratios of the given line. ये given line के direction ratios हैं. ठीक है? ये direction ratios हैं. अब उनको चाहिए डायरेक्शन कोसाइंस चाहिए गिवन लाइन के. तो डायरेक्शन कोसाइंस तो एक खास नंबर्स, वो भी डायरेक्शन रेशियोज होते हैं, मगर वो एक्स्ट्रा कंडीशन सेटिस्फाई करते हैं कि एल स्क्वायर प्लस एम स्क्वायर प्लस एन स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू 1. सो हाउ, इफ डायरेक्शन रेशियोज आर गिवन ऑफ अ वेक्टर, हाउ टू फाइंड द डायरेक्शन कोसाइन? ए डिवाइडेड बाई ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर प्लस सी स्क्वायर, बी डिवाइडेड बाई ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर प्लस सी स्क्वायर, एंड सी डिवाइडेड बाई ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर प्लस सी स्क्वायर. इन दिस वे यू विल गेट द डायरेक्शन कोसाइंस. सो हाफ ऑफ द क्वेश्चन इज सॉल्व. We have found out the direction. We have found out the direction cosines of the given line. Now, what is the next step, and why we are needing these direction cosines? क्योंकि जो दूसरा line है, जो इस line को parallel है, दूसरा line जो किसको parallel है, तो ये direction cosines वहाँ हमारे काम आएंगे. How they we will utilize these quantities? Let's see. Now, equations of the line to the point this and parallel to the given line are. अब देखो बच्चों, वो जो जो जिस लाइन का हमें इक्वेशन तलाश करना था, यू नो वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड द इक्वेशन ऑफ अ लाइन, यू नो वन पॉइंट इज ऑलरेडी गिवन, So x minus x1, y minus y1, z minus z1. Very simply, you utilize this point over here, and you in the denominator you directly use the direction ratios of the above line, because ye dono line parallel hain. Ye wala line, let me maximize this one. You can see, if you see, this was the given line changed into the symmetric form, and this is the desired equation of line which was parallel. And you know, when two lines are parallel, so it means that their direction ratios will be proportional, or you can say same. So that is why 5, so we plug here 5, minus 1, so we plug here minus 1, and 2, so 2. So when two lines are parallel, so mean that they will have same direction cosines, their direction ratios. Okay, so that is the answer. If you feel any difficulty, please let me know. I'm here to answer you. If you have any question, please. I'm here to
सर, ये क्वेश्चन नंबर 11 में हमें इनको सिमेट्रिक इक्वेशन में लाना
सिमेट्रिक
तो कल हमारे पास क्वेश्चंस थे, उसमें से सिमेट्रिक फॉर्म के लिए जब पॉइंट मालूम कर लेते थे तो उसमें हम जीरो जेड जीरो पुट कर लेते थे तो हमारे पास एक्स एंड वाई में इक्वेशन आ जाते थे, तो हमारे पास पॉइंट आ जाता था सर. तो क्या वो प्रोसीजर यहाँ पर इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं कि पुट जेड इज इक्वल टू जीरो तो पॉइंट आ जाएगा, या ये जो प्लेन होंगे जो ओरिजिन से जेड एक्सिस को जीरो पॉइंट पर क्रॉस करेंगे या नहीं करेंगे सर?
हाँ
हाँ, मतलब z इज इक्वल टू 0 क्या वो केस ले सकते हैं यहाँ पर या नहीं ले सकते?
आई थिंक दैट अगर हम कैन यू रिकॉल द क्वेश्चन, व्हाट वाज दैट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर व्हिच वन?
यस सर,
व्हिच
क्वेश्चन नंबर, आई थिंक इट वाज क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 और 10.
Okay, let me see. So let us go to the solution. Let us this is not 9, this is 10. Okay, so if you see the kindly I ask you switch off your mic.
Yes sir.
Okay dear Ayaz, the line is okay in that question, equation of line are these two. Okay, if z is equal to 0, we got two equations, and when we got two equation and we in x and y, you simply solve them, you get the value of x and y. So we find out the point on a line. Okay, if l m n are the direction ratios of the line, so of course, so yes, Ayaz, you can do that method as well. You are right, can do that method as well. Like your question is how to convert general form of equation of line into the symmetric form of equation of line. So you are right, Ayaz, we can do that method as well.
Okay sir, thank you sir.
Okay, very good, shabash. So now we come to the question number 12. Let's see what is in question number 12. Find the equations of the straight line passing through the point 3, 4, 5. Okay, point of that line is given and intersecting the z-axis at right angle. Achha, ek point ka given hai, aur hume, let us make a diagram so we can understand this. Suppose we have z-axis. We have the coordinate axis, I mean x-axis, and the third coordinate axis is y-axis. So you can see we have now 3D space, R cube. Okay, they are saying that there is a line which we need to find is actually perpendicular to the z-axis. Perpendicular, making 90 angle with the z-axis. And it is passing through one point. A point can be given here. What is that point? Let me see the point. It is basically 3, 4, 5. Okay, 3, 4, 5 lies in the space. Suppose 3, 4, 5 is here. 3, 4, 5. 3, 4, 5. Okay. So we have been given a line which is passing through the point 3, 4, 5. and which is perpendicular to the z-axis. So of course, here if you see what will be the that intercept, I think that surely it should be 0, 0, 0, 0, and 0, and 5. Of course, it should be that because the line is perpendicular. So it seems like this. Anyhow, let's see what is the scenario. Okay, so question number 10. If okay, so question number 11, sorry, question number 12 is saying that find the equations of a straight line passing through the point 3, 4, 5, and that equation, that line is intersecting the z-axis at right angles. So let's see, question number 12. Direction cosines of z-axis are, uski wajah kya hai? Why we are finding the direction cosines of the z-axis? As we are interested in the equation of a line, but why we are needing the direction? You know, there are many methods to solve that single equation. For example, one I was telling you from this solution manual, and other, you know, Ayaz, he recalled the previous question, and he said that we can solve the same question on the old method. And I said, yes, we can do that. So to solve a single equation, you may have various methods. Okay, so direction cosines of z z-axis are 0, 0, 1. Yeh direction cosines hai, theek hai? How they are direction cosines of z-axis? If you see, my dear student, you can simply solve it. Like, suppose this is your z-axis. Okay, and what is our target, my dear student? Our target is basically to find the equation of this orange colored line. We need its equation, but this line is given to be perpendicular. This orange colored line is given to be perpendicular to the z-axis. Now we should know about the z-axis. Okay, what are its direction ratios? First of all, direction ratios, you know, you can obtain it very easily, direction ratios of z-axis, because we know z-axis is a line. And by direction, let me write direction ratios. Direction ratios. Direction ratios of a line mean that direction ratios of the vector which is lying on the same line. So if you see 0, 0, 1, this is actually direction ratios of this vector. So this is direction ratios of this line. A student can tell me, sir, zero, 0, 2 is also direction ratios. I will say, yes, of course, this is also direction ratios of this line. So if you see, my dear students, you can very easily find the direction cosines. What is the formula? We know that L is equal to A divided by A square plus B square plus C square. Similarly, M is equal to B divided by A square plus B square plus C square, and so on. So if you see in the solution manual, question number 12, direction cosines of z-axis are 0, 0, 1. Let the direction ratios of the required line be, jo ki hame jo orange colored line tha, let us suppose the direction ratios are LMN. Since the line is perpendicular to the z-axis, so we will have their dot product will be actually 0. So mean that 0 into L, 0 into M, 1 into N is equal to 0. So from here you get N is equal to 0. Jab aapke paas ye N 0 aa gaya, so what it means? When the N is actually 0, so it means that the equation of line through 3, 4, 5 are actually, this is actually a little bit long method, you know, if you see. Like you can do directly one thing, that a line was passing through 3, 4, 5. Okay, so mean that this is one point. And it is perpendicular to the z-axis. Was z-axis ko perpendicular hai. So of course, what will be the second point? The second point is of course 0, 0, 5. It is so shortcut method. I think you should try this. एक पॉइंट तो गिवन था कि 3, 4, 5, और दूसरा पॉइंट क्या है, उन्होंने कहा था कि ऑरेंज कलर्ड लाइन जो है जेड एक्सिस को 90 एंगल पर कता कर रहा है, तो दूसरा पॉइंट आपके पास क्या हो गया बच्चों, 0, 0, 5 हो गया। ना हमारे पास लाइन का इक्वेशन है एक्स माइनस एक्स वन, एक्स माइनस एक्स वन डिवाइडेड बाय एक्स टू माइनस एक्स वन, सिमिलरली वाई माइनस वाई वन, आई एम सॉरी, इजिकल टू वाई माइनस वाई वन डिवाइडेड बाय एक्स टू माइनस एक्स वन इज इक्वल टू जेड माइनस जेड वन डिवाइडेड बाय सॉरी वाई टू माइनस वाई वन इज इक्वल टू जेड माइनस जेड वन डिवाइडेड बाय जेड टू माइनस जेड वन। सो दिस इज सिंपल माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, सो यूज दिस टू पॉइंट्स एंड यू विल जस्ट गेट द डिजायर्ड इक्वेशन ऑफ लाइन इन दिस फैशन। दोनों पॉइंट आपके पास आ गए तो आसान है आगे, तो आप बहुत आसानी से इसका इक्वेशन क्या कर सकते हो बच्चों, कैलकुलेट कर सकते हो। ओके, नाउ वी आर इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 13, यू विल गेट दिस इक्वेशन। अच्छा, क्वेश्चन नंबर 13 जो है वो क्या कह रहा है, दिस इज एक्सरसाइज, फाइंड द एंगल बिटवीन द लाइंस। एक हमारे पास ये लाइन है, यू कैन सी दिस इज वन लाइन इंटरसेक्शन ऑफ टू प्लेन्स एंड दिस इज अनदर लाइन इंटरसेक्शन ऑफ टू प्लेन्स एंड व्हाट वी नीड टू डू, वी नीड टू फाइंड द एंगल बिटवीन दीज टू लाइन्स एंड यू नो दैट हाउ टू फाइंड द एंगल बिटवीन टू लाइन्स इज एक्चुअली एंगल बिटवीन देयर टू वैक्टर्स। सो ऑफकोर्स वी विल बी नीडिंग द डायरेक्शन रेशियोज, हमें डायरेक्शन रेशियोज की जरूरत होगी। उसकी वजह आपको अंदाजा हो जाएगा कि दिस इज रियली सिंपल क्वेश्चन। हाउ, क्वेश्चन नंबर 13, इफ यू सी माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, the given lines are, this is first line, this is second line. If L1, M1, N1 are the direction ratios of the first line, then we know that 3 into L1 plus 2 into M1 plus 1 into N1 is equal to 0. We have already discussed this concept yesterday, two times. Similarly, 1 into M1, 1 into L1, see the coefficient of Y. So this is 1 into M1. And minus 2 into n1 is equal to 0. So solving these two equations, why we are solving? Because इस तरह first line का जो direction ratios हैं वो हमारे पास आ जाएंगे, क्योंकि angle को calculate करने के लिए आपको दोनों लाइनों के direction ratios चाहिए। अब आपके पास दो equations हैं और तीन unknown हैं, आप कोई भी method use कर सकते हो to solve these two equations. So the basic method is cross multiplication method. So ये cross multiplication method से आप जो है ना इसको बहुत आसानी से कर सकते हो। तो आपके पास पहले लाइन के डायरेक्शन रेशियोज आ गए। अब आप बच्चों ये दूसरा लाइन ले लें और उसके सपोज कर लें L2, M2, N2 आर द डायरेक्शन रेशियोज ऑफ लाइन 2, तो उसके मुताबिक आपके भी दो इक्वेशन आ जाएंगे सेकंड लाइन से। अब आप उसको जो है ना क्रॉस मल्टीप्लिकेशन से सॉल्व कर लें तो उसके भी डायरेक्शन रेशियोज आपके पास कैलकुलेट हो जाएंगे। अब एंगल का फार्मूला क्या है, एंगल का फार्मूला ये है कि इफ थीटा इज द एंगल बिटवीन द टू लाइंस देन वी नो द फार्मूला फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस chapter that cos theta is equal to A1A2 plus B1B2 plus C1C2. आप इस तरह कह सकते हो L1L2, M1M2, N1N2, both are, look, L1, M1, N1. It means the same direction ratios, not the direction cosines. Direction cosines can also be used, it will be create no problem. But direction ratios is simpler. So simply multiply the direction ratios of the two vector, they take their dot product and divide by their magnitude. So you will get zero. And we know cos, shifting cos to other side, so cos zero is equal to 90. You mean the two lines are perpendicular to each other. So that was very easy. At any point, if you have any question, I feel that you are now a little bit expert in solving these questions. That is why I'm just, you know, like we are in the end of this exercise, so that is why I feel you are understanding this. Prove that symmetric equations of the line formed by the intersection of the two planes. Acha, my dear student, this line is given to us. This is actually a line, and we need to simply convert it into the symmetric form. They are saying that these are two planes, they are intersecting. You of course, these two together will represent a single line. You simply change into the symmetric form. And you know how to change into symmetric form? You know two methods now. But anyhow, let us do it. So we are in a question number 14. The equations of the given line are, of course, this is the equation of plane, this is equation of plane, but these two together. Now, if you see, my dear student, whenever you get a single equation in three variable, a linear equation in three variable, ax plus by plus cz plus d is equal to zero, and of course you know it represents a plane, but when you write two equations of plane, it will represent a single line, and that line will be their intersection. Now, like Ayaz pointed out, that we have two methods now. So if you put some variable zero, and like in this way, if we solve, can we do it? So the answer is yes, we can do that. First, what you will be needing? You are needing a point, and you are needing the value of LMN, the direction ratios of that line. And it is easy to find its symmetric form. Now, first we find a point on a line. So you simply put, suppose x is equal to zero in both the equations. When you put x is equal to zero in both the equations, so double bache over ban ka, okay, ha ban ka ha. Now if x is equal to zero, we have, so you have two equations in x, in y and z, okay. So you got these two. You simply solve these two equations simultaneously. When you solve it simultaneously, my dear student, you will get this point on the line. Now what we need, why we need this point, my dear student, if you see, this is actually two point form of equation of a line, but you know there is another symmetric form. In symmetric form, we need the direction ratios over here. So actually we are actually converting given general equations into the symmetric form. So here we need the direction ratios. Even the direction cosines are fine, no problem, and direction ratios, okay. Do remember, direction cosines are also can be termed as direction ratios, but direction cosines are little bit special because they have to satisfy extra condition, you know, L square, M square, N square. Anyhow, so you have find out one point on a line. Now what you are needing, the direction ratios of that line, and once you get it, you can simply convert that line into the symmetric form, okay. So we get a LMN or the direction ratios of the given line. Agar LMN hai, to iska matlab ye hai ki normal ke sath wo kya honge, perpendicular. We have discussed this in last class. So it means that 2 multiply by L, this coefficient minus 5 multiply by M, and this coefficient 1 multiply by n is equal to 0. This is first equation. Now using the second plane, 1 into L, 1 into M, and minus 2 into n is equal to 0. We got two equations and three unknowns. You can use any method, elimination method. You can use matrices to solve it, and you can use cross multiplication. This is cross multiplication method. You know this, okay? So this is cross multiplication. If you have a problem, we can solve it. Please, if you can, so you can switch on your mics, you can ask me. Now this is actually direction ratios. So I mean, L is 9, M is 5, N is 7. Hence the equations of the line in symmetric form is, so ye wo point tha jo aapne talash kiya tha, 0, 1 bata 9, 14 bata 9, wo minus kar le isse upar, aur denominator mein LMN ki values laga de. Just plug the values of LMN in the denominator, and you will get the desired equation in the symmetric form. So bacho, this is the end of the exercise and end of the lecture as well. As today I have told you, we will take a short class because today's topic is up to only 14 questions, the last question, and today's lecture was only based on the exercise 10.3. so inshallah we will meet inshallah, of course, after the Eid, okay? ठीक है बच्चों, तो अल्लाह आप सबको कामयाब करे, ठीक है, और just keep us in your prayers.